This is Tattoo Overview, and last time on our last episode, we talked a little bit about how tattoos age in skin. Let's take the path of a photon of light and follow it as it travels through the skin, hits the particle of ink, and then travels back to our eyes.
What is the base skin tone of this person? And what wavelengths of light would be on the other side, essentially, of a color wheel? Because those are the ones that are gonna give me the problem. So there's a base level that you can see everybody shares, so you can calculate that. There's wavelengths of light that will be absorbed by skin, irregardless of your skin tone. And then you have to start adding on the cell diameters. As people get darker, the cells that make our skin look darker actually get much, much bigger. The trick is to get everybody to have a standard way to classify skin types. So what we did as a first step is we looked at all the skin classification methodologies that are out there for medicine and found some massive holes in there for tattooing. It wasn't capturing the full color gamut of human skin. So what we ended up doing is scraping the internet for hundreds of thousands of skin samples and then boiling all that down to find out what is the true skin tone color palette. And we found that there's actually a warm palette and a cool palette because you have the red and the blue shift. And then chunked that out to 6 samples on either side, so a total of 12 different skin tiles. And with that, you should be able to classify all of your clients and all of skin tones. So that gives you a base place to start and a way to formulate color palettes, because you'd have essentially 12 different groupings of 6 potential colors. Some of them will overlap for sure, but then those are your optimal ones, and ink manufacturers can focus on those. And the goal with that would be is, as tattooing evolves and you're trying to share a technique with a colleague and you said, oh, I was tattooing this person and she's a 3, everybody knows what you're talking about. So you know for 3s, this would give you the result. And the 3 is going to be very different than the 6. And as more and more dark-skinned people get more and more tattoos and that becomes more of a thing, it gives you a way to delineate, okay, I've got a 6 and I've got a 2. How do I deal with clients that are in that range, and what's optimal for a 2 and what's optimal for a 6? Mm.
Along those lines, since you bring up darker skin tone clients, and we had kind of teased this or maybe talked a little bit about it in a previous episode, are there any ways to amplify that healed wavelength of light? So let's say it falls out, the blue falls out early in darker skin tones. Is there any way that we could pick it back up?
So one way to do it is you have all of these photons being scattered underneath the skin and throughout the skin cells. There's compounds that you can use that refocus that light, almost like a top coat or a clear coat that you put on a car. They reflect specific wavelengths of light. You would need to know the base tone that you're dealing with and then put those compounds into the skin so that they amplify that light, and then you would get more vibrant colors.
You wouldn't put them in at the same time as the initial tattoo?
It's almost like a tattooing top coat. Hmm. Yeah. To get more technology into tattooing ink, only thing that's really holding it back is ways to describe it. So if you say all tattoo inks are the same, and obviously you have this huge range of skin tones and they're not broken into chunks that you can study, it makes it really hard because it's just such a huge problem. And if you ask a tattoo artist for input, or for somebody in the industry for input, and there's not a common language, it makes it even harder. So if we can define some of these terms and variables, then you can look for appropriate technologies to make the experience better, make the outcome better. But the big problem right now is, how do you organize this huge phenomena that has all these artistic aspects? And the way that you describe the phenomena might sound really scientific, because a bunch of propeller heads are going to use big words for it. And then the artists have their own language, and then figuring out how to really harmonize all those things so that everybody's saying the same thing and they're after the same goals.
It's not unlike some of the problems that we're trying to solve in design and in drawing. Terms like value and contrast and edge, and things that we teach a lot on this show, it's having a common language so that whenever you say something, people read it the same way.
Absolutely. And music's a really good place to look at, because it's got a really defined structure. You have to play in a key, only have 8 notes, you have a certain range of octaves, and there's rules to music. But look at how infinite music can be in its expression form. It just helps when you're trying to teach someone how to play a guitar to say, okay, this is how we're gonna notate everything. That's kind of really similar to the problem in tattooing. We just need to get everybody on the same page.
Thanks again to our top secret S8 chemist. Those are some pretty bold claims. You know, I've been a big proponent of limited color palettes just to simplify my process, but you know, a 6-color palette that's ideal for a particular skin tone, that's not something that we've ever heard before in tattooing. And it's a really interesting topic to me, and I'd love to dive deeper into it. If you guys would like to learn more about it, please share your thoughts in the comments below. Reach out to us, let us know if it's something you'd like to for us to explore more. Thank you guys, as always, for supporting the Fireside Tattoo Network. Thank you to S8 for sharing their knowledge. And that's it. See you guys next time.
Hey, I'd like to give a special shout out to our great friends at S8 Tattoo. Click the link in the description below to check out all of their fantastic tattoo products, and be sure to use the code FIRESIDE at checkout to get 10% off. While you're surfing the wild, wild webs, you might as well swing over to firesidetattoo.com and check out all of our online courses and workshops. Maybe pick up a t-shirt from our sweet merch store. Finally, I would like to invite you to subscribe to our channel so that you can stay up to date with all of the goings on and be notified when new videos drop each week. Thank you so much for supporting what we do, and we'll catch you next time.